As you all know, OnePlus 7 Pro comes at the starting price of 49,000 rupees. Do you think it is as good as OnePlus 7 phones used to be in terms of value for money? And do you need those extra features which you get in OnePlus 7 Pro compared to OnePlus 7, which comes at just 33,000 rupees? So should you buy OnePlus 7 Pro over OnePlus 7? Let's find out in this video. Hey guys, this is Vibhav and you're watching Vips Tech. Let's get started. There's a lot to love with this phone, but there are few things which is not so good, especially when you consider its price. Glass and metal design is great, it is flagship grade, premium and gorgeous. Plus this phone's front, which is the biggest highlight, and it lives up to the hype. The display here is big and vibrant and it looks stunning with its curved style. Also, the multimedia experience on this phone is way better since there is a minimal bezels and no camera cutout or notch. Another feature of the display is its 90Hz refresh rate, which means your overall scrolling in the phone will be smoother. But most of the games does not support 90Hz refresh rate as of now. This phone has stereo speakers, which is also good. I love how the OnePlus 7 Pro looks, but what I personally feel is it's too big for one-handed use. I personally like the display size to be 5.5 to 6 inches. That is a perfect size for a smartphone. But now all the phones are coming with bigger and bigger displays. OnePlus 7 Pro comes with 6.42 inch curved display, which is good for multimedia, but it does not fit comfortably in my hand. So I decided not to go with OnePlus 7 Pro. But that's my personal opinion. If you have no issues with big phones or you like big vibrant displays, you can go for it and you will not be disappointed. But there are few problems with this phone which I'll talk about in later of this video, so make sure you watch till the end. Next, if we talk about the cameras here in OnePlus 7 Pro, it has 48 megapixel plus 8 megapixel plus 16 megapixel rear camera. Though this looks good on paper, but the camera quality in real life usage is not mind-blowing or flagship grade. OnePlus is using same Sony IMX sensor which is used in Redmi Note 7 Pro, which is just 14,000 rupees. Phone. When I compared the front camera with my OnePlus 6, there are some improvements and selfies taken on OnePlus 7 Pro are sharp and detailed. The one thing of this phone is really impressive, and that is its performance. The flagship chipset, Snapdragon 855 and lots of RAM up to 12GB and a well-optimized Oxygen OS make the OnePlus 7 Pro one of the fastest phones. One more thing which really make the difference and make this phone faster than the other is the UFS 3.0 storage. Compared to 2.0 storage, UFS 3.0 is twice faster. This means faster app load time, faster game loading and faster file saving. All around faster experience along with Oxygen OS 9.5 has some new features. New native screen recorder, new gaming mode and new Zen mode and lot more. Plus Oxygen OS will soon get some India specific features via OTA update. Battery backup on OnePlus 7 Pro is just okay. It has 4000mAh battery, but it has bigger 90Hz display and it eats more battery. Though in moderate usage, you can expect this to last you for a day, but if you are a heavy user or you use the device extensively, you will need to plug it for a charge by evening. It has fast charging, I would say very fast, 30W rapid charge. Your phone will be ready in no time. Rapid charge charges the phone 10 to 100% in just 80 minutes. At the end, let's talk about some problems with this phone. It has no IP rating, no wireless charging, no Gorilla Glass 6, even though you get Gorilla Glass 6 in OnePlus 7, which is much cheaper than OnePlus 7 Pro. If you're okay with these missing features, you can buy OnePlus 7 Pro, but if you want to save some money, I would say a lot of money, you can go for OnePlus 7. Yes, when OnePlus 7 Pro launched, no one was excited about OnePlus 7. But when they announced the price of OnePlus 7, everyone went crazy, and think of those who bought OnePlus 6T recently. OnePlus offered a discounted price for 6T and it was available at 32999 on Amazon just before few days of OnePlus 7 release. Now someone who bought 6T, as other reviewers said, is true. 2 minute silence for them. Because OnePlus 7 comes with better specs as OnePlus 7 Pro, but at a lower price. It has same chipset, same UFS 3.0 storage, same primary camera and same software experience at more value for money price tag. So if you're buying OnePlus 7 Pro, you're buying it for that 90Hz display and yeah, maybe for that moving pop-up front camera. Apart from that, I would say OnePlus 7 would be a better deal for the price. Although OnePlus 7 will have lot of competition very soon. The Zenfone 6 and Redmi K20 both are expected to be coming to India soon with flagship specs, bezel-less design and similar pricing as OnePlus 7. So it will be interesting to see how OnePlus 7 fares against them. Let me know what do you think in the comment section below, and it takes lot of effort to make these videos, so like dislike based on what you feel of this video. Lastly, if you haven't subscribed yet, press that subscribe button to see upcoming videos, and I will see you in the next one. Till then, goodbye.